Hey guys! Welcome again to one of our Ninja Monkeys tutorials.
Today we will talk about enumerations. An enumeration is a user-defined data type, composed of a comma-separated series of components. You have to declare it in a DUT. In the project tree, you open your PLC project and right-click on the DUT. In the context menu, select the command Add and select DUT. A new dialog opens. Here you can select a type. As you can guess, we select enumeration as type. Now we give it a name. We name it bColor, because in our example we do an enumeration with components named by the different states of a banana. From green to yellow to brown to invisible, because a monkey ate it. Haha. You can check the command Textlist support if you want. This enables localization of the enumeration component identifiers and a representation of the symbolic component value in a text output in the visualization. We don't need this right now, so we do not check the box. Now we can declare our enumeration. On top we see two attributes, qualified only and the attribute strict. We will talk about the attributes and their use in a minute. Beneath them the type definition starts with type followed by the enumeration identifier. Between the brackets we can start our enumeration. The definition ends with end type. We delete enum member equals 0. This is a preset component, and start with our enum components, separated by commas. Green, yellow, brown, eaten by a monkey. An enumeration can have any number of members, but need to have at least 2. In our case, the values of the members are automatically initialized, starting at 0. The values for the following elements are continuously incremented by 1. You can also explicitly assign fixed initial values to the individual members. In our case, green is 0, yellow 1, brown 2, and eaten by monkey 3. But we could also explicitly assign a fixed initial value to yellow or any other member. The data type of an enumeration is int by default, which means our lower bound is -32,768 and our upper bound is 32,767. If you want, you can define another basic data type, like, for example, sint. The data type must be an integer data type. If you want to define another data type, you do this behind the closing bracket. Here you can also specify a default value for initializing all components. The initialization of individual enumeration values is also possible. If you assigned a specific value to a component, the following components will align. To brown we assign the value 7 and eaten by a monkey's value is 8 now. If it makes sense for your purpose, you can initialize every component with a different value. Note, it is not possible to give two components the same value. We have our attributes on top. These are optional. The enumeration name. Next, our component declaration. Here you can set the basic data type. You can use the following basic data types: uint, sint, usint, dint, udint, lint, ulint, byte, word, dword, lword. After the data type, you can do a default variable initialization and declare explicitly one of the members as initial member. Let's now go to our main program. In here we will write a little program to demonstrate the enumeration. We want to display the different states of a banana. Therefore we will use a case instruction. With the case instructions you can combine several conditioned instructions with the same condition variable in one construct. That fits perfect for us and our banana. First we declare 3 variables. The first one is called banana color with our user-defined data type, aka our enumeration, and we initialize it with our first component, green. Next, we declare a variable with the data type string. The bText variable will display our current banana state. And last, a variable with the data type bool. We will call it a day later, because when we set it to true, one day has passed, and our banana hopefully will change its color. Before we write our case instruction, we will add another useful attribute to our enumeration and explain it. The toString attribute. This pragma has an effect on how the result of the conversion of an enumeration component with the operator toString/toString is output. If the enumeration declaration is provided with the pragma, the name of the enumeration component appears as a string instead of the numerical value. This is what we want for our little program. Btext will now display the component name, and the components are named by the different colors or states of the banana. At first we write btext equals now we use the toString operator in brackets we write banana color. Now let's start with our case instruction. We write case banana color of. We start with our first component of the enumeration. Green. Oh, look what happened. We got an error.
Yeah, Ajnan. That's right. That's because we used the qualified only attribute in our enumeration. This attribute forces us to specify the enumeration name to access our component. We can't just write green, we have to write bcolor.green. If we comment the attribute out in our enum declaration, we get no error. But we really recommend to use it. Because for example, if we declare a variable with the same name, TwinCAT takes it instead of our enumeration component.
Okay, it really makes sense to use it. And what about the strict attribute?
I will explain it to you. In our example, we use four different colors to display our banana. We initialized the elements with their RGB values. We got another enumeration. Here we have a lot of different color elements. The enum color has no strict argument. The enum b color has one. We declared two variables. Banana 1 with our b color enum, and banana 2 with our colors enum. If we try to assign a value from our colors enum, which is different to the values in the b color enum, we get an compile error. Only elements of the enum colors with the exact same value of the elements in the b color enum can be assigned to banana 1. It is also not allowed to add values. This also leads to a compile error. Without the strict attribute, we could use an enum variable like a normal integer variable. We can assign the element eaten by a monkey of enum b color to it. Note that the enum colors has no element with the value of 0, like eaten by a monkey, but it works. Without, you can multiply two values or add values, for example. The attribute strict results in compile errors occur in the following cases. Arithmetic operation with variables of the enumeration type. Assignment of a constant value, which is not an enumeration value, to a variable of the enumeration type. Assignment of a non-constant value, which has a data type other than the enumeration type, to a variable of the enumeration type.
Nice, thanks for explaining it. Let's now write our case instruction to display the different states of our banana.
Yes.
We write case banana color of bcolor.green colon if a day later then banana color, colon, equal, bcolor.yellow, semicolon. End if. We repeat this for all states of the banana. After the end case, we write a day later, colon, equal, false, semicolon. Now let's build it and log in. We start the program. Our banana is green. After one day it is yellow, after two brown, and on the last day one of us ate it.
Nice. I am hungry now.
Yes, me too. I think that's it for today.
Yeah, have a great time.
We hope to see you soon. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for not missing new videos. Bye.
Bye.